Just thought I'd do a really quick one this week because I didn't do anything on Christmas Day. And this is again about C# version 9 and just primarily how you can get it working in Visual Studio. I showed you a little bit of this last time when we were looking at the init keyword, but I didn't really go into too much detail. So that's what I'm going to do now. So what we need to do, if we want to create a C# 9 project, we'll go into Visual Studio, we'll do create a new project. And to start with, what I was actually showing you last time, I'll just repeat myself a bit. We were looking at just create a console app, say, .NET Core. And then if we click on next, we'll give this a name. So this is CS9 demo and create that. And the problem is that actually we don't yet have C# 9. So if I were to just straight in here, try and use a feature. So I'll just say class, some class. And then let's have a property of type string called name. And then if I try to set that to init, which is the new keyword that we've got in C# 9, you can see it's complaining that we've not got that. We're currently in C# 8. And so the way I showed you to fix that is to go into the project. And if you haven't already got it, I have. But if you haven't, go to install other frameworks. That will take you to the website, and then you can download the SDK, whichever version you want, for .NET 5, which will give you C# 9. So download that, I won't show you that because I've already got it. And then all you've got to do is make sure you then select .NET 5. And now if we go back to our program, we can see it's now perfectly happy with that init keyword and will be with all the other new C# 9 keywords and features that we'll be looking at in subsequent videos. But the bit that I didn't mention, which is really, really important, probably more important than what we saw here, is how we can get C# 9 into libraries, into DLLs, rather than into applications. So let's do that. Let's add a new project, and let's make this one a class library, so .NET standard class library. Click next on that, and so we'll call this CS9 library. Click create. And let's just copy that same code so that we can just see whether things are working or not. So I've been given a class 1. I won't even bother to change that. But we'll see. We're getting the same sort of problem. So it's, in this case, actually telling us it's C# 7.3. Because the problem is here that if we look at the properties of the library, it's actually defaulted to 2.0. So if I at least set that to the latest version of 2.1, then the error it would give us would be now that we're using C# 8, not that we're using C# 7.3, but it's still not C# 9. And the problem is, you'll notice there's nothing there at all. So although I could select .NET 5 as a platform for my actual executable, I don't get that option available when I'm doing with the DLL. And so what I've got to do is actually a couple of things. I've got to go into the actual project file, and then on this property group we can put in a section called lang version, and in there we could either put 9.0 if we wanted really precise targeting, though what I tend to do is you can just put in latest, and that just will be whatever the latest version is. So that will mean this will upgrade automatically when new versions come out, which you may or may not want. That's what you can go for. Now then, if we look at the class in there, we can see if we do a rebuild, it's still actually giving us an error, and it's giving this strange error. System.runtime.compilerservices.isExternalInit is not defined or imported. So what we've got to do is actually create this class that it's looking for ourselves. The system.runtimeCompilerServices is external init. We need to put that into our project. Now, we can put it anywhere we like in the project. It's just got to be there. But actually, there is a file that's been used for a long time for this sort of thing, which is assemblyinfo.cs. In .NET Framework, if ever you created a project, you would have been given for free this assemblyinfo.cs, and what it contained was all of the assembly level attributes for the project. We don't get that for free in .NET Core or .NET 5, but we can create it anyway, and that's a good place to put this thing. So all I'll do is, on my library, I will add a new file and call this assemblyinfo.cs. Now that obviously creates a class called assembly info, but we don't really need that. We want to put this other thing in for ourselves. So in fact, we can strip all of this out. And remember, this thing that it's not got is in that specific namespace. So actually, we extend effectively the system namespace for this. So we're going to say namespace system.runtime.compilerservices. And in there, we put this class. So we have a public class, and then just call it is external init. And that is what makes this all work. So now if we do a build on that, you can see that's perfectly fine. If we look at our class, you can see it's now understanding that. So it's a bit tricky to have to do. A couple of different ways to do it for different circumstances. But when you've got an actual executable, when you're definitely using .NET 5, then you just have to set the target framework. When you've got a library and using .NET Standard, then you need to go into the project file, you need to add the latest version, and you also need to add that is external init class to keep everything happy. But once you've done that, then that should get you going. You should be able to use C# 9, and we'll talk about some more of the actual features of C# 9 in the various videos coming up. So do please subscribe to get hold of those. If you like that video, do like it, and I'll see you next time.